Miu Quijada to serve. Love to all.
Love one.
A little break off the net for Wang Manyu to start. Power from Sun Ying Sha. It's going to take some extra, I'd say, closed rackets. Weight forward from the Japanese pair. Easier said than done when you're sharing space in real time. And this backhand, no chance, is deep to the corner and as fast as can be. Tight, heavy underspin serve. So the winners here will be playing the winner of Chun Siyu and Cheng Xianzhi versus Jun Jihee and Yang Haun. Chinese Taipei team and Korean team. So fast start for the Chinese pair. On the receive and serve, flawless so far. Good placement behind the momentum, controlling the over-the-table game. The Chinese pair right now. We're looking at world rank number 2, Sun Ying Sha, and world rank number 6, Wang Manyu. Both of whom could be world number 1 in the near future, but I think Sun Ying Sha, the way she's been playing lately, and just her proximity to the position, will be number 1 quite soon.
6-1.
A little off the edge with the punching backhand from the short pips. Backhand side of Quijada. Oh, not too common we see this. As a matter of fact, I can't remember the last time I saw it. Professionally in doubles with a player who just hit the ball, got hit with the ball trying to get out of the way. Fang Zhendong successfully getting out of the way of shot of the year. Technically point of the year, but it was the shot that won it. So 3 in a row for the young Japanese duo. Heavy spin coming in. It's up to calibrate as Nagasaki tries to counter. Not the first time we've seen heavy rotation. Again, the wingspan of Wang Manyu greater than anyone on court right now, which means more racket speed coming into the ball.
3-9.
Second towel break, only Sha Sha, that's Sun Ying Sha, and Wang Manyu going over to the towel.
Let 3-9. 3-10.
This low spinny one from Sun Ying Sha earns 7 game points. The Chinese pair to take the first game. The two in blue break on through. They take game number 1, 11-3. Dominance. Ah, good angle both ways. One wide out to the forehand from Quijada, and then quick the other way. As I mentioned before, the Japanese women have a pamphlet that was distributed in 2014, but they generally have a way of being positive between points. Right back down the line, Sun Ying Sha, quick. It's tough to stay positive after a point like that is played. But you will see it. You'll see smiles. You'll see head nods of, okay, I got it. I know how to move forward. Look at what Sun Ying Sha did to the ball. Inside out, gets low. Bending the upper body to get around. Again, that core strength and leg strength.
3-1.
It's funny. You might get a sense seeing her on screen. She looks very innocent in many ways and not threatening. But Sun Ying Sha just is able to be so dominant when she twists and turns. Say the same thing about Mima Ito in terms of size or sheer mass. Oh, nice strawberry. But no problem, Wang Manyu deals with the spin. Works with it to drive it deep to the backhand corner. Very patient opening spin shot. Wang Manyu confident it would come off the table. Just had to give it time so she could get her full stroke in.
7-1.
Score line quite similar to game number one. Came down on the wrong side of the table for the Japanese pair. But the right side for Sun Ying Sha and Wang Manyu to continue their dominance. Both sides have the strawberry if they need it. Good follow-up attack down the line. Not easy to execute that shot. And again, it's coming off of short pips to add insult to injury. Good use of side spin on this bend. From the strawberry, the point before, to the backhand we just saw, mixing it up a bit, breaking the rhythm. It's worked out well for the Japanese pair to get a few more points. Two more on the scoreboard.
9-3.
Confidence from the middle of the table. Wang Manyu with the opening, the follow-up forehand opening to Sun Ying Sha as the ball came wide. 6-point advantage for the Chinese pair, looking at a 2-0 lead in the near future if they continue. And disguise deception out here. Wang Manyu gets in with the wrist cocked back. Finds the opening on the table, 7 game points. Favor returned, opening spin from Nagasaki inside the table. The Muse saving game point. Good touch to keep it shallow and low to the net as well. Long serve, clipping the net on the receive. Wang Manyu and Sun Ying Sha go up to a 2-0 lead. Miu Kihata with the serve.
One love.
Quick timing here. A difference already we see in the timing. Nagasaki with a shorter stroke. It's funny, this is one of the main things that I would say is the difference between Asia and Europe. Simply the timing. I don't know if I can say simply, but there is a difference in timing drastically. When you think about 2 decades ago when Europe was slightly more competitive with Asia, there was a later taking of the ball. Meaning if the ball dipped and you would spin a little bit, okay, no problem. Back when short pips and flat hitting was more common in China. We had the Waldners and the Pearsons spinning wherever they could. Wow. Came back over the net after one bounce. Heavy backspin in the push. Check this out. One, and I don't want to be there anymore. Oh. Good angle here. Wang Manyu guides it back out. Only the second point, though, for Sun Ying Sha and Wang Manyu. You might think surely they're secure with a 2-0 lead. It's early in the game. And you're right about the fact that it's early in the game. But in terms of security, things could turn quickly. It's a best of 5. Oh, spectacular rally, the smothering shots. The backhands of Miyu Kihata, you can hear it when it hits the short pips, the flat hits. Nagasaki spinning from behind the table. It's a 3-point lead for the Miyus. Forehand flick attempt, blocked by the net. Back within two, Wang Manyu and Sun Yingsha. Backhand punch and dodges the ball as well. Again, a darting backhand. If you're gonna have short pips on the backhand side of the racket, there's one player to look at right now, one role model who happens to be not too far in proximity in terms of national teams, Mima Ito. A good tight shovel serve as well. No matter who wins this, I'd love to see it go to the fifth. The decider. And the Miyus working hard to slowly make that happen. An encouraging lead, but not comfortable. We've seen bigger deficits recovered. Perfect positioning down the middle of the table. Able to drive the opponents off into the backhand court. Get the step around once. Bit of traffic in the deep backhand court. Second towel break, and only the Chinese pair using. And now 7 game points to get their first game on the scoreboard. The Miyus with a second serve. Right down the line, Miyu Kihata takes the game with Miyu Nagasaki, 11-3, the same dominant from placing themselves in the final. Oh, what an angle! Wang Manyu on the run, this shot is very unlikely. I thought the Japanese pair had both of them. Wang Manyu and Sun Yingsha exactly where they wanted them. And a tucked back wrist leaning to the side still hits a winner. But not this one. This time around, it's Nagasaki on top of the bounce. Slow start, but still early in the game. The dismissive forehand from behind the table. Sun Yingsha just dropping the hammer one more time. Spin comes in. Sun Yingsha just sends it off to the barriers. Some of the loudest grunts we've heard, the effort from Wang Manyu and Sun Yingsha to follow. 1-point game, second serve here. Sun Yingsha drives the ball off in the pocket.
2-4.
Now the way that came off the racket, normally a player would look down at the racket just to see if there was a wet mark, but didn't seem to be the case. Nagasaki just having some trouble on the receive there. Understandable, Sun Yingsha with Wang Manyu waiting for a third ball. That's a lot of pressure to receive. Leaning back, a slower shot from Sun Yingsha, but heavy spin in the timeout on the Japanese side. 3-point lead for the Chinese pair. Resting position. Resting smile face, RSF. Although we caught Coach Rui Nakazawa in between for a moment, just concentrating, and as the signals are given on receive, a 2-point game now. Well protected on the serve. Wang Manyu with the shovel serve. 3-point lead back to the Chinese pair. Good quick wide push. Loaded with spin in the angle. sharp as well. Oh, the punching backhand is fast as can be, a bullet backhand. Not even touched on the other side. On top of the bounce, Quijada. Again, bringing the muse 1 point closer. Shovel serve and the follow-up down the middle of the table. It's tied up at 6 points apiece. Remember, this is the game. It's gonna go to a decider. The Miyus have to win this. Nice change of pace there from Nagasaki. Side spin and top spin into the middle of Wang Manyu. Heavy spin on the step around. Miyu Quijada, flat hitting back. A little bit behind the ball. Say about a 75%, maybe even less. Fairly cautious shot. It seemed as if she was saying, why not get more aggressive?
7-6.
Strawberry again. Chole indeed as Wang Manyu spins it back on the parallel. 2 point lead back to the Chinese, two in blue. Big spinny backhand cross court. Remember, less spin on it than most despite the motion in the timeout on the Chinese side. So we'll see how things go. Down by one, the Japanese pair. Oh, a swing and a miss from behind the table. It started off just the way predicted with Wang Manyu on the other side, stepping around for the backhand over the table. And into the exchange, the Chinese pair behind the table. Nagasaki just a little bit late on this, tough to time. 2 point lead back to the Chinese pair. Outstanding play on top of the bounce. It all started with a tomahawk chop block and the touch after that to follow. The fast footwork of Wang Manyu and Sun Yingxia. Punched back from Nagasaki on top of the bounce this time around, and Quijada goes down the line just out of reach for the point. A 1 point game once again. Japanese pair, the Miyus, down by one. Heavy rotation from Nagasaki, powered through the legs and spun up deep on the table. 9 points apiece here in game number four. Serves with the Miyus, a chance to convert these two and send this to the decider. Again, we're looking at world number one versus world number two. How did that happen in the semis? Well, based on seeding and how they performed as a team in 2019. Sun Yingxia, Wang Manyu, the third seeds. Miyu Quijada with the serve. Tight shovel serve and a slow spinny backhand from Miyu Nagasaki. It is game point for the Miyus.
Please, let's play.
Polite request. To not stall. Another shovel serve, it looks like. 10 serving 9. That serve was so good. And still, Sun Yingxia managed to spin it up from under the table and take the point. Side and topspin, a very awkward, uncomfortable ball. Miyu Quijada's serve just barely drifting off the table. That serve wins the point for most pairs. Deuce game number four. Caught in between the slow spinny one from Wang Manyu earns match point for Sunying Sha and Wang Manyu to move on to the women's doubles final. The heavy spin countered back, a closed racket near the table. Miu Kihata stays on top of the bounce. When you've got Wang Manyu grunting for the opening attack, you know it's not easy to deal with. 100 revolutions per second for a Chiquita, a backhand over the table. Primarily topspin though, so you just say a backhand opener. Push to set it all off. Miu Nagasaki just long. Match point number two. The flat hit down the middle of the table. Miu Kihata. Again, the short pips in that rocket backhand. Now the fact that you just saw her clean her short pips the way someone would normally wipe the top sheet of rubber is a good sign that she's not afraid to spin with them. And that even though there's less, say, surface area touching the ball, less traction in that sense, it's still important that the short pips are clean and she has the traction and the control. Out of the fourth towel break, 12 points apiece. Short stroke, and Miu Kihata covers right back to the middle of the table. Game point once again for the Miu's. Ball kid with some serious stomp action. And the shot does it from inside the table. The flick with little rotation. Miu Kihata leaves an awkward ball. The Miu's at the top of the screen representing Japan. A solid opening from Wang Manyu to protect. Put pressure on for the third ball. Now, one thing I haven't mentioned yet, Sunying Sha and Wang Manyu, world champions in 2019 in women's doubles over a Japanese pair, but it wasn't this pair. It was Hina Hayata and Mima Ito, who were quite strong in doubles, Guinness World Record holders, 2017 Dusseldorf. And the off-speed pace here to the middle of the table as the right-handers run around to get in position. Wang Manyu chops. What more needs to be said? Have you ever seen Wang Manyu chop? And it was right at the baseline of the table. In case you question if there's any limit to the skill sets of these players, this just pushes the boundaries and the imagination for what you can see coming out of these players. Wang Manyu's chop was nearly perfection in terms of placement. Sunying Sha stepping around for that backhand. 2 points quick the other way. The women in blue in the lead. Sunying Sha now on the receive a second time. Shorter side of the table though. Ball just a little too long for the table. Really makes me wonder, again, about the positivity, the happiness. Oh, Sun Yingshan near the ground, reaches out and at full extension keeps the ball in play awkwardly and uncomfortably. That's a very difficult ball, not just to get back on the table, but to play against. Leaping. Ball very shallow. Miu Kihata on the attack with Wang Manyu getting back in position. That long jabbing push, darting in. Miu Kihata has been quite effective with that on many occasions. One of many receives that we've seen from her. Ties up the game, 4 points apiece. After this point, they will switch sides and order of play for balance throughout. Heavy spin from Wang Manyu into the backhand corner as Nagasaki turns. Tough to stay on top of the forehand. It takes a little bit more time for the backswing there. By that time, the ball has already reached its peak, maybe even on its way down, but tougher, you're further from the net. So now five serving four, or four serving five, rather. Kihata to Wang Manyu. Oh, switch, I'm sorry, to Sun Yingshan. They started game one and game five.
Five.
The other order. So here we go.
Let 4-5.
Now you might recall the placement of that serve as the ball drifted just long. Sun Yingshan was able to make a quality receive. The high backhands are so tough to deal with, and just when you think it's impossible, Sun Yingshan just moves that much faster. Wang Manyu, but that one right there, Kihata ripped the ball deep to the corner. And from behind the table with short pips on the backhand side, it's tough. Less arc on the ball, but that rally, just incredible. It gives a 2-point lead to Sun Yingshan and Wang Manyu. Parallels again, right down that line, drilling it. In this point. Again, Sun Yingshan, Wang Manyu grunting, giving everything in their body, every ounce of muscle and effort to cover this shot, cover the middle with the forehand, play the short side. Kihata on top of it, and Nagasaki spins one more time. The perfect shot, the perfect point, and it only ties up the score. Thumbs up indeed. We like. So the plot thickens as the score is dead even now in the decider. And after the absolute spectacle that was put on the point before, there's a little bit of a downer the next point, a quick one to go, but not a downer for the Chinese pair right now. A quick point that was much needed after all the effort put in the point before. Just simply by quality of point and length of point anyway, from a spectator's standpoint. But again, this is the greatest war in table tennis. Right now, it's a battle between China and Japan. We're looking at the world champions. Well, right now we're looking at world number one versus the world champions. Interestingly enough, by world ranking, the Miu's individually relatively low on the list for the women. And a 1-point lead for the Japanese youngsters, the Miu's. As Don Parker would say, we're getting into the business end of the match here. And the plot continuing to thicken. flat backhand of Miyu Kihata comes back. It is so tough. Watch Sun Yingsha's counter of this flat backhand. Punched right out to the backhand side, and at full extension, Sun Yingsha still able to loop it. Yeah, that face says it all. The world has watched Fan Zhendong do that and marveled at how impossible it seems, and Sun Yingsha just did the same thing here, under pressure in the decider. Timed again. Well played from Sun Yingsha, and Wang Manyu to hang in there. The change of pace throughout these rallies. Heavy spin from Nagasaki, soft block from Wang Manyu, and a punch shot a bit flatter, tough to counter. A rhythm breaker from Sun Yingsha, especially considering the shots she's already pulled off. The crowd reminding the women in blue where they are. The opening backhand, Sun Yingsha earning match points two times over for the world champions. Right down the middle of the table. And the serves are on their side. Sun Yingsha serving a match point. Rally that got Sun Yingsha and Wang Manyu chasing around behind the table. A lot of work at every moment in this rally. You think to yourself, the quality of shot coming in at the Miyus is going to be very tough to deal with. And Nagasaki with the racket high prepared, and once again a high racket. It's Kihara to finish, saving match point. One more to go. Second serve here for Sha Sha. Match point, two times over. The Miyus extend this to deuce in game number five. A spectator's dream right now, no matter who wins, it will be an incredible relief and a very satisfying victory. But only one side can win. Serves now with the Miyus. Nagasaki, serve on her racket. Trying to stay cool. Calm the nerves, dry the palm. Yeah! Will a long serve and a follow-up third ball attack set up match point? That's three in a row for the Miyus. On the receive now, what's it gonna be? We know that Sun Yingsha and Wang Manyu have that over-the-table backhand that's been effective. Pressure of the highest order.
Please.
I'm surprised. Oh, they're going to hold on for a moment. A ball kid getting that ball that we saw in the background for a moment.
11.
10 serving 11. The Miyus receiving on match point. Just long, and the Chinese pair fight to survive. They extend the match, saving a match point of their own. Long push to the backhand corner, and Kihara's backhand just long down the middle of the table. Lee Swin reminding his team that he's there in the corner. The world champions right now. Fighting for survival, tied up again, second deuce point. Miyu Kihara with the serve. What a receive right down the line, short side, and Sun Yingsha's got the crowd jumping here. Volunteers in the crowd jumping at the sight of that shot. Match point once again, third match point. As they practice a little football there over by the barriers. For the short side of the table to sneak it around Wang Manyu, a very difficult position. Sun Yingsha doesn't miss by much. Had the shot come down, it would have been trouble. Nagasaki there waiting. The Japanese pair, the Miyus, bring it to a fourth towel break. 12 points apiece. Remember, you're looking at world number one in doubles, the Miyus, versus world number two, the world champions. Wang Manyu on the left and Sun Yingsha on the right. Forehand flick kill sets up another match point for world number one, the Miyus. To stay calm in that moment. Reminder, there are two tables going on right now. I'll tell you more about that in just a bit, but quite a spectacular rally on the second table. Imagine having to deal with that while you've got match point against you and on your side at the same time. That's what this table's dealing with. Match point for the Miyus. Counter back, they do it, the Miyus take it, the smothering backhand, Miyu Kihata with the flat hit, and it is victory from down 0-2, absolute domination in the first two games, 11-3 and 11-4, the 15-year-old and 17-year-old sensations from Japan.